down. Paid the cost to be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna give you guys some tips and tricks of how to sell. I know a lot of you either have never sold before, don't like to sell, get nervous selling, don't know what to do when people say no, and sometimes it could just be a little like overwhelming, right? Especially if you don't have experience, if you're not confident in your sales skills or some of that or whatever, right? What I want to say is, if you know how to sell the right way, then selling is not scary at all. You got to think to yourself, what does it mean to make a sale? Like, what does that mean? Like, what is a sale? Right now, I mean, to break it down, basically a sale is you taking money from someone for a product or a service that you offer, right? Whether it's your own or you're doing it for another company, on behalf of a company, you're selling something, right? Now, for those who say, well, I've never sold anything before, you know, I don't know how to sell, then I say that's bullshit, because you do know how to sell, you just don't realize it. So let me ask you this. Do you have any friends? Do you have a boyfriend, a girlfriend, a husband, a wife? Do you have a pet? You ever befriended a stray animal, like a stray cat, right? My point is, somehow, some way, you convinced this person or pet to like you, to trust you, right? And how did you do it? You probably made yourself very approachable, very safe. You know, you made yourself interesting, right? You showed them your features and benefits, so to speak, right? What makes you cool? What makes you interesting? What makes you funny? What makes you fun to hang around with? You let that be known in some way or another. You let that be known. You let people come to that realization by themselves, right? But really, it was you indirectly influencing them to see or notice all those things that you wanted them to see or notice. Think about that. You made a sale right there. That's what selling is. In that situation, whether it's a relationship, in a, like an amorous relationship or a friendship, right? What you're doing is you're selling yourself. You're selling these people the idea of you. You're selling them the idea of why and how you are as cool as you think you are. And when they accept that idea, the sale is complete. You got a new friend. You got a boyfriend, a girlfriend, a husband, a wife. You got what you wanted. That's what a sale is. Okay, so now you know what a sale is, right? But still, you're thinking, well, okay, I get it. How do I do that though? Well, there's you could be the typical salesperson, which everyone hates. That can, you know, here, I hate salespeople, and this is coming from someone who's worked in sales pretty much my entire life. I am a salesperson. I'll sell you shit, you know? The thing though is that you won't notice that I've sold you on something until you're swiping your card. And that's how you do it. You don't want, here's a little tip. Write this down. This is a good quote. I don't know where the hell I got it from, but it's true. Ready? Everyone wants to buy, but nobody wants to be sold. So think about that. Every time you go down to the mall, whether you have something in mind specifically that you want or you just want something like in general, you're there for a reason. You're not there to window shop. You're there to see what you want to. You're there to see to buy. You're there to buy something, right? You're there to buy something. So what you don't want is people approaching you, taking you out of your rhythm, out of your flow as you're wandering the mall to try to convince you to buy whatever the fuck they have to offer, right? We all know those guys from Sprint and AT&T or whoever, T-Mobile, all you guys in the kiosk. Like, dude, like, you guys are doing it all wrong. You're giving salespeople a bad rep, right? If I'm walking down with my family down the mall, and I see those guys at the kiosk, ah, man, like, I know. Don't make eye contact with them. Don't look at them. Don't look at them. Why? Because they're going to say, hey, how's it going, man? Hey, what cell phone company do you use? Dude, I have, like, get the, no, right? You know, I don't want to deal with that, right? Why? Because that's the wrong way of doing it. And that's probably why you don't like selling shit, right? Nobody likes that. As a consumer, you don't like those people. And as a salesperson, they're not going to like you, right? So don't do that. Don't be the salesman. Instead, be the influencer. Influence someone into buying. Again, like the relationship analogy, you didn't walk up to somebody and say, hey, how's it going? I think you're awesome. By the way, I'm really awesome too. You should be my friend, or you should be my boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever, right? No. Now, if you have those kind of balls, then that's a different topic. Then you're like 10 steps ahead of the game. Then go for it. Then just do your thing. You got the balls, go for it. You're not afraid of rejection or whatever, go for it, right? But this is for everybody who is, you know, intimidated or gets nervous or whatever, right? So here's an example of a sale, a different sale, right? Let's say that, I'll give you a good example and a bad example. How about that? I want you to come and eat at this restaurant for whatever reason, right? It doesn't matter. I want you to try this certain restaurant, okay? The bad example. So I tell you, hey, I went to this place, you know, on the weekend. You know, it was cool. Prices were all right. You know, food was cool. You should check it out sometime. That's a bad example, right? I have no desire to go to this restaurant at all. I don't care what it's called, where it is, how cheap it was. It sounds like shit. I am not interested at all. It could be delicious, but I won't know because you did a shitty ass job of convincing me, right? Here's a better example. Now pay attention to how I'm going to say this. That's not a turn lane. Motherfuckers. They always fucking, it's a straight lane and they always try to fucking turn right there. They get pissed off at me and shit. Anyways, so so let's say, again, restaurant. Sorry, I got distracted. I'm trying to convince you to go to this restaurant. Here's a good example. Okay. You're my boy, right? You're my friend. You're my coworker, and we trust each other. Like, we're cool. Now I'm saying, hey, man, I went to this restaurant, you know, over the weekend. Like, my friend was telling me, like, you know, hey, we should check it out. And I'm like, I didn't really want to, you know. I have, like, my own set of restaurants that I like going to, you know what I mean? And those are the ones that I stick to. Those are my diehard, you know, go-to places. But my friend was like, yeah, you should try it, you know. And then we're going to go with a group of people, and they all wanted to go there. So I'm like, all right, fine, whatever, you know, I'll check it out. You know, I'm pretty open to try new things, so it is what it is, whatever. So we go there, right? And it's over here in this one part of town, you know. And when we get there, you know, we open the doors, and the first thing was like, boom, like, oh, dude, like, it smelled hella good, right? Just from the outside of the parking lot, right? You can see, like, kind of like the smoke coming out from, like, the top of the roof, you know. I'm like, damn, like, that smells good. Like, what is that, right? Anyways, we go inside, right? And it looks pretty cool, you know, from the outside. But we will go inside, and, like, it looks, like, really nice. Like, it's, like, kind of has a sort of, like, dim lighting, you know. It's decorated really nice, you know. It's, like, it's pretty peaceful in there, but, like, the smells were like, oh my god, like in, like, the in the cartoons where, like, the smell is like doing like this, you know, and like it lingers you over. It was like that, right? Plus you walk in and, like, you can hear, like, the food, like, in the background, right? I can see, like, the flame, like, in the back of the kitchen, you know. And then, like, the servers are, like, walking around with, like, the platters of, like, stuff, and it's, like, sizzling, and, like, oh man. And, well, guess what? You're probably imagining this fucking restaurant, aren't you? Right now. I'm not analogy no more. No more story time. You're imagining that restaurant, and it's probably making your mouth water. And you really wanted to know what place this is. You imagined it just however you imagined it. And I didn't tell you what color the walls were or what kind of food it was, but you imagined it how you imagined it, right? I painted a picture in your head, and then your imagination ran wild with it. Guess what I just fucking did? I just sold you the idea that this restaurant is fucking badass. And as soon as I'm done with my story, what your next question was gonna be, Where's it called? Where is it? I sold it. I sold it to you. That is how you make a sale. That is how you sell. Okay? You don't come up front and say, hey, I'm awesome, you know, come buy my shit, you know. You paint this beautiful picture in their head of how awesome it will be for them. You paint this experience in the person's head, right? You make them come to you. And notice how I did it. Yeah, I didn't really want to go, you know, but I ended up going. And then I talked to you about, I made you imagine, you know, from the moment the door opened of the car, how I smell this delicious food, how I see the smoke coming out of the chimney, how I walk in and it's super elegant looking, you know. I described everything. You probably imagining, like, you know, like the sounds, the smells, everything, you imagined it. Salesmanship is in the storytelling. If you can tell a good story, then you can make a sale. Okay? So that right there, that alone, now run with that idea. That alone should get you past the hump of I don't know how to sell and the nerves of selling. Don't be a salesman. Everyone fucking hates a salesman. I hate salesmen, and I'm a salesman, right? I hate the salesmen that fucking suck at their job, that don't know how to sell, because they ruin it for everybody else, right? But if I'm trying to sell you on something, I sell you on the idea of it.
Get down! Paid the cost to be the boss.